Last week, we aired a story about Jeremy Romero. He's the Corrales police officer that was badly hurt in a high-speed chase that ended in a crash. We told you that Denver police had stepped up and were offering Romero a mentor while he stays in the hospital.
And today, KOAT Action 7 News reporter Angela Brower is live in Corrales. She has a story that you're only going to see on 7.
Good morning to both of you. This is Corrales Road. This is really where that accident happened. Officer Romero was, of course, chasing after a white Honda Accord, trying to pull it over when it took off, and he had to chase that vehicle. They ended up going more than 100 miles an hour at times, and that's when he hit a guide wire here and flipped his vehicle. This morning, we're talking to the people that are standing by his side during this very difficult time.
Denver police officers called Action 7 News after we ran last week's story, wanting to weigh in of what it is they're doing to help Corrales police officer Jeremy Romero.
This is pretty bad.
They call it one of the worst cases they've ever seen. Romero is now recovering from broken bones and facing the possibility of paralysis after a horrible accident the morning of January 21st. After the crash, Romero was sent to Denver. Craig Hospital is one of the best in the country. That's when Denver police stepped in, helping what they call their brother in blue.
There's one thing about law enforcement. You know, we feel a bond. We have a brotherhood.
It's part of a program they have in the Mile High, helping injured officers who come in from around the country. They provide support, people who have been in those situations before, and also resources to the entire affected family.
When they start to feel a little bit better, we try to get them tickets, get them and the family to go out, you know, do, you know, family outings, try to bring their lives, you know, being a little bit normal.
And I'm told they even take wives shopping. They take them to grocery stores so that they can cook a home-cooked meal. Again, all to make everything feel a little bit more normal. Now, remember, if they're not at the hospital trying to help their loved one recover, the family is at the hotel. And we're told for the Romeros, it is going to be a while before they're back in New Mexico. Reporting live on Corrales Road this morning, I'm Angela Brower, KOAT Action 7 News. More in the morning.
All right. Thank you, Angela. And we're also told Romero is still in good spirits and has high hopes to get home as soon as possible, even though it might take a while.